Ah, yes, Napa, California. Sometimes referred to as the Italy and France of the United States, nearly 5 million tourists a year flock to Napa Valley to drown themselves in wine, food, and art. It's a Disneyland for wine drinkers and food lovers. Summer is peak season here. Hotels sell out on weekends, and this is definitely not a place to visit with no reservations. Not unless you're Anthony Bourdain. The city of Napa itself? Population 74,116. Maybe even more by now. The city of Napa is conveniently located at the south end mouth of the 27-mile-long, vineyard-covered Napa Valley. It's also an approximate 75-minute drive north of San Francisco, if you're lucky enough that there's no traffic. But we're really talking about two Napas. There's the wine-drenched, sun-baked, artsy, and foodie Napa, as seen and experienced by those googly-eyed visitors. Then there's the real Napa in its entirety, as seen and lived by the locals who live and work here. The polluted Napa River that used to flood regularly every few years, traffic, red light runners, gangs, potholes, buckling sidewalks, rainy winters, construction, overpriced cuisine and boutique shops, a not-so-lively after-hours downtown, everything else the tourists see, and a city government criticized for catering to the tourists over the locals. Don't get me wrong, there are plenty of good things about living here. This place is all about alcohol and drinking. What's there not to like? But seriously, we have scenic roads outside the city limits, historic Victorian neighborhoods and downtown, and one-way streets. Okay, maybe the one-way streets don't qualify. There's also a relatively low crime rate, a lot of restaurants to choose from, and some pretty damn good food at that. There's hiking trails, picturesque valley if you don't mind vineyards invading every last square inch of land, and warm and sunny summers. Oh, and did I mention good wine? What put Napa Valley on the map is the wine, of course. And more recently, the food has helped make Napa Valley what it is today. After all, what good is wine without food? But it always amazes me how a glass of rotten fermented grape juice draws crowds from all around the world. Wine's become a cultural phenomenon. Who would have figured? There are way over 300 wineries in Napa Valley. Many of them are known around the world. This is the premier wine-growing region. With the city of Napa, the hub of Napa Valley, and gateway to Napa Valley, downtown Napa has an interesting scene. You would think that a world-class destination would have an epicenter that never sleeps. Wrong. Despite the fact that Napa Valley sees more than 5 million tourists a year, downtown Napa has seen mixed results. Not exactly a rockin' town at night, and sometimes even lethargic during the day on certain days, downtown is often seen as lacking something to both the tourists and the locals. One problem is the location of the hotels. With only two hotels in downtown proper, and all the rest off in the shadows, tourist foot traffic in downtown is not to its full potential. The second problem is the retail space rents that some of the property owners charge. With some of the rents tickling the stratosphere, potential retailers are either scared away or have to charge high prices on their goods, leaving many vacant storefronts. And lastly, a general lack of after-hours entertainment. There is, however, a little live music at a couple restaurants and bars a couple nights a week, and an occasional performance at the local opera house. Otherwise, one would think they stumbled upon a modern-day ghost town driving through downtown at 12 o'clock in the morning. But the restaurant and wine bar scene is fortunately very well off, with a mix of first-class Italian, French, American, Napa Valley cuisine, among many other ethnic gastronomic wonders. Wine bars have been popping up here in increasing numbers. This allows tourists to liquor up without having to drive up valley to the wineries. That could be a good thing. But major changes are currently well underway in Napa in the form of a huge revitalization project in an effort to make this place what it really should have been 20 years ago. Almost everywhere you look downtown, you can see it happening. Cranes mingling with the sky, construction equipment, signs saying you can't go here, hotels, resorts, condominiums, retail and office buildings under construction, and also newly built ones. Even a major flood control project underway for the last several years, and another many years before completion, to tame our local river running through downtown that had been notorious for flooding and drowning parts of our city every few years, with an appetizing brown and muddy water resembling God knows what. But our town is fortunately and finally changing. We think and hope for the better. The idea is to permanently eliminate winter floods and draw more tourists, merchants, and residents to come here by completing this flood control project and building more hotels, five-star resorts, condos. Retail spaces, offices, remodeling our downtown park, building a river promenade, and overall beautifying our city, making this an even more welcoming and fitting first-class destination. The need for a new and hugely improved Napa has been known for years and is finally on the front burner. Unfortunately, this has drawn a hurricane, and I'm talking a Category 5 here, hurricane of criticism from the native Napans who feel this explosion of growth is all for the tourists and has no benefit to the locals, and in fact are worried about losing the once small town feel. I hate to break it to them, but Napa has already lost that small town feel it had up until 15 years ago, in my opinion. What do you expect for a population of 75,000, possibly even more by now, in a city the size of a postage stamp? What's my take on all this development? Do the words job opportunities, economic growth, and revenue for the city mean anything? Enough said. Without the tourists, our town would be a gas station and a stop sign. Well, maybe not literally, but you get the point. Napa, like most other American suburbs, is largely a fast-growing middle-class community. Many residents who live here work somewhere else, and many workers who work here live somewhere else. The dilemma seems that it's too expensive to live here, and many of the jobs are relatively low-paying tourist-related service jobs. Now, I'm not saying there aren't other kinds of jobs that pay big bucks, but with all the wineries, restaurants, hotels, resorts, and boutique retail, this is, not surprisingly, a service industry town. Napa Valley, among many other places in the world, is a millionaire's dream. This is a very popular place where the wealthy come to play and live. Take a look around. You'll see golf courses, country clubs, world-class resorts, low-flying corporate jets making their approach into Napa Airport. Oh my God, is that Bill Gates? And even monstrous homes appearing along mountaintops, staring down at us. The demographics in Napa are pretty similar to many other California towns. Aside from the predictable Caucasian makeup of the population, there is a large percentage of Hispanics. Some were born here, but many of them immigrated from Latin America to seek a better life, and a huge portion find jobs as vineyard field laborers, helping transform the almighty grape into the mesmerizing liquid we call wine. Aside from that line of work, the other jobs some natives claim they'll refuse to work are filled by the immigrants, seeking any work they can find. They are known to be extremely hardworking, dedicated, and productive workers. Unfortunately, an unknown percentage of them came here illegally. As there is everywhere else in the United States, there is much debate about illegal immigration and whether it provides more harm than good to our economy and industries. But one thing I do know for sure is that although Napa, at least until the revitalization project is complete, in some areas is not the most beautiful or exciting town I've seen. But we do have awesome wine, restaurants, wine bars, and a gorgeous valley, scenery, and character. Whether I can afford it is another matter. But my synopsis of Napa is a matter of personal opinion. So whether you're thinking about moving here or just visiting here, Napa is more than just wine and food. It's about character, scenery, and the people that live and work here. See you soon.